Hi, I'm Zor. Welcome to Unizor Education. I would like to offer a logical problem. This is problem number 10 in the part called Logic of the Course Math Plus and Problems presented on Unizor.com. I suggest you to watch this lecture from the Unizor.com website. You just choose the course Math Plus and Problems, the category Logic, and this is Logic number 10 lecture. You will see it, because on the same page you have video presentation, whatever I'm just doing right now, and you have textual presentation of the same problem. In many cases, I do I put on the same page solution to this problem as well. So it's always useful first to check the problem itself, try to solve it by yourself, and only then you can read the solution, whatever I'm suggesting. Now, in the lecture, I will present the problem first, and again, I suggest you to pause the video and think about it. It's very important that you think about the problem before you read or watch the solution to this problem, because the whole course is about, well, thinking. Analytical thinking is something which can be developed, and problems, especially math problems, logical problems, geometry problems, etc., which I'm trying to present on this course, Math Plus and Problems, they do help to develop your analytical abilities. Now, this course is actually the second one. There is a prerequisite course called Math for Teens, primarily directed to high school students, where I present all the theoretical material which, generally speaking, the high school student must actually master, starting from something very elementary like numbers, and ending in calculus and all the different aspects of it. So, back to business. So, a logical problem, which I call sophisticated here, well, it's subjective opinion, so maybe it's simple for you, maybe not, I don't know. So here is the problem. There are two friends, mathematicians, Mike and David, and they have both know a girl called Helen, also a mathematician, a very good one, at least as good as they are. And during the conversation, they are asking what's her birthday. They wanted probably to present some gift or whatever. Now, she has decided to test their logical skills. And instead of just saying when her birthday is, she gave basically a riddle. She gave the following dates: May 15, 16, 19, June 17, 18, July 14, 16, and August 14, 15, 17. Then she gave the real month of her birthday to Mike. So Mike has months, and David, she gave a day of the month to David, and basically said, okay, without telling exactly what I gave you, you can say something, but not exactly answering what exactly I gave you. Try to figure out my birthday. So, then they were thinking about, the friends, Mike and David were thinking about, and at certain moment, Mike said something, then David said something, and they figured out the birthday. Actually, Mike said only one statement, and then David said one statement, after which everything was basically clear to them. And here are the statements, and what I'm basically asking is, I will give you what kind of statements they gave, and I will give you the opportunity to pause the video and think about it, and then I will present the solution. Okay, so, Mike said the following. Let me write it down. I cannot determine, but David definitely cannot either. So that's what Mike said. Now, David was thinking about this and said, well, it's true, I could not determine, but now, after Mike said what he said, I can. After which David said, Mike said that he can too. So this is Mike, this is David. Mike, I can too now. So basically, how can they did it? How did they do it? All right, so basically, again, it's a good time to pause the video and think about it. Basically, every part of the information given is needed for logical conclusion. And let's just think about it. Okay, so now I'm presenting the solution. First of all, David has a day. Now, look at these 2 days. They are unique. There is no other 19 and there is no other 18 among all the dates. So let's assume that Helen's birthday is on 18th or 19th. Then David would immediately say, I know. But he did not. He said that he knows only after Mike said something, whatever he said. So whatever Mike said was very, very important for David to make a decision. So let's just think about it. Why do you think Mike cannot determine? I understand. I mean, obviously there is a big choice of 4 different months, so obviously he cannot determine. However, he said that David definitely cannot do it either. How does Mike know that David cannot determine? Well, let's just think about under what circumstances David can determine. Only if it's given, only if he's given 18 or 19, because these are unique months, unique days of the months. So if David was given one of these, then it's definitely a solution, and he would immediately say that if he gets 18, he said it's June 18th. If he gets 19, he would say it's May 19th. But he did not say it. So again, how can Mike know that David cannot determine under one and only one circumstance? Mike sees the months, and the months cannot be May and cannot be June. Because if Mike sees May, then there is a possibility for David to knows the birthday. He cannot say that definitely cannot. He cannot, Mike cannot say that David definitely cannot determine. How does Mike know that David definitely cannot determine? Because Mike definitely knows that it's not in May and not in June. So Mike has the months, and the months is not May and is not June. It must be July or August. Again, if the months which Mike gets is May, then there are some circumstances under which David could have determined, because there might be there is a chance that it's 19th, and if this is a chance that David probably would be able to. However, David did not say a word, and Mike knows that definitely David cannot do it. So it's not May and it's not June. So we completely scratch these dates. So that's what the first statement of Mike information gives to David. So now David knows that it's not May and it's not June, which was given to Mike. So Mike has only July or August and these two dates. Okay, that's good. Now let's think. Mike said whatever he said. Now David said, I could not determine, but now, after Mike said what he said, I can. So now David, thinking basically the way how I was just explaining and understanding that this is July or August, he said that he knows the birthday. Now let's think about it. How can David know the birthday if it's one of these? Well, it's only if it's not 14, because 14 repeats twice. If his number is 14, he wouldn't know it's 14th of July or 14th of August. So it means that number given to David is not 14. So he knows only if it's 16, 15 or 17, and seeing basically the day, he basically says, okay, if he gets 16, he knows it's 16th of July. If he gets 15th, he knows it's 15th of August. If he gets 17, he knows it's 17th of August. So he knows the birthday, and that's what he said. I could not determine before, but now, after Mike said whatever he said, so after we have reduced our search to 2 months only, now he knows, and again, he can say it only if the day which he sees is not 14, because if it's 14 in front of his eyes, then he would not be able to say that he knows, right? So now Mike understands that this is not 14. Okay, great. So we have reduced it to 3 different dates. Now, Mike says, I can too now. So I can determine right now. Mike has only the months. How can Mike say that he can determine the date, the birthday, now? Well, if it's August, then Mike wouldn't know it's 15th or 17th. So he can say this statement only if his month is July, and then there's only one date remaining, and that's 16. So we, knowing only the answers, only the conversation between these two guys, so we can determine that they can say whatever they said only if it's July 16. So July 16 is Helen's birthday. Very quickly, let me just repeat it. Because Mike said that he definitely knows that David cannot determine, it means it cannot be May or June, because May or June have unique dates, and David would be able to, if it's one of these, if Mike has May or June, then in theory David might have 18 or 19, in which case basically he would determine with 100% probability correct birthday. So Mike knows it's not May and it's not June, because these two would allow David, in certain cases, not in all cases, but in some cases, to determine this word definitely, or for sure, or without any doubts, or like there is no chance that David would be able to guess. So these are all mean exactly the same thing, and they mean it's not June and it's not May. Now the second could not determine before, but now when 2 months are out, now he can determine. So now he has only these 5 dates, and if he says he can determine, it cannot be 14. In all other cases, they're all unique now. Now these are not there right now. These are all completely out. So among these, 15, 16, and 17 are unique. So date is sufficient to determine the birthday. So it's definitely not 14, and that's what this particular statement gives, that's information with this particular statement. So before he could not determine, but now when these 2 months are out, he can, which means he has in front of him one of these 3 dates, and in all cases, day is sufficient to determine the birthday. And now, since 14 is out, that's what Mike now says. Now Mike says, I can now determine it. So again, if it's August, he would not be able to say this word, because he doesn't know what day it is. But if it's July, there is only one date. So if the month given to Mike by Helen is July, only in this particular case, he can say that he knows the birthday, and this is July 16th. Okay, now, whether it's sophisticated or not sophisticated logic, it's you to decide. My purpose was to basically explain this logic and basically say that, you see, such a seemingly insufficient information is really sufficient. So it's like a detective's work, like Sherlock Holmes, basically. By nuances of whatever somebody says, definitely or no doubts about or no chance, etc. This is a nuance which is very, very important, because it immediately scratched 2 months out of it. And in this case, before I could not, now I can. Now the way how he can determine is only if he has a unique day. And the uniqueness is 16, 15, or 17, not 14. So it's all one after another little piece of information which helps. And finally, both of them understand what exactly the day is. Okay, so I suggest you to go to the website, unizor.com. Go to course, math, plus, and problems. Choose the category logic, and this is logic number 10. Read again the problem, and now basically you know the solution. What I'm suggesting you is, I wrote the solution basically in the same page. After I present the problem, I wrote the solution. I would suggest you to just have a piece of paper and write down, well, maybe not a piece of paper, maybe you write it on the computer, some notebook or whatever. So write down your logic. It's extremely important if you write it down yourself. Now you know the solution basically, right? So you can read it if you want. But what's important is to, after you have familiarized yourself with this solution, write it down. And then compare to whatever I wrote on this web page. Well, that's a suggestion, and I hope you will follow it. Other than that, we are done. Thank you very much, and good luck.